gamers. Now, you know NVIDIA has gone back and taken Quake 2 and created a fully path-traced version. That means full ray tracing version of Quake 2, the true classic game. But what I want to know, as someone who lived through the 1990s testing hardware with this game, I want to know if this version still works the same as it did back then. I'm going to show you how to benchmark it. Check this out. You hit tilde, you pull down the console, you type time demo, one, space, and then look, I'm taking you all the way back to the 90s, kids. You type demo, space, demo one, press return, game runs with the settings you picked. Looks pretty fast to me. Come back, hit tilde again, you get your frame rate. 97.9 frames a second, but you know, you can't run it once. You've got to run it a few times, do the average, yada, 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 that stuff. But 100 frames a second, fully path traced. For the record, this is on a GeForce RTX 2080 Ti. But let's see what settings I ran. I'm gonna go into video. Of course, in the old days, you weren't running 1920 by 1080, but look, there is support for multiple GPU on this card. I gotta break it to you, bad news, that doesn't mean two RTX cards in SLI, that probably means it supports two Voodoo 2s in SLI. What's awesome about this is Quake 2, 1990s gaming, modern hardware, available June 6th. You'll be able to get this game, run it on your card, and see what you can get with those instructions.